much longer is this gonna take?
Your daughter's on the line, just running the encryption.
Black hell!
What's up, Gerb?
The data you glommed off the rig. There's no way the Georgians could have gotten this much intel without a man inside the CIA.
Fisher, you're up.
Dad?
Sarah, hi.
Where are you?
On my way home.
I thought you were gonna call last week.
Something came up. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Were you in Georgia?
Honey, you know I can't answer that.
Yeah, I know. I was just watching it on TV. Oh!
Sarah. Sarah!
Oh, shit!
Back to third echelon.
I'm here, Fisher.
What the hell's going on?
Nicolas just declared war on the U.S.
What?
The Georgians hit our communications, transportation, power grids. We still don't know how extensive the damage is.
What's our defense? What are we doing?
What do we have? Nicolas caught us with our pants down. All we've got is the laptop you pulled off the oil rig.
My daughter.
I know, I know. I've got people heading over there. This whole country's a mess.
I need to see Sarah.
You know what you need to do. We're helpless until we find Nicolas. You're heading for the CIA. Your mission just became critical.
Failure at the Red Bear Army Community Hospital in Mississippi resulted in 17 deaths and over 30 injuries. Both county electricity and backup generators were destroyed, leaving military train traveling to Norfolk, Virginia, collided with a commuter rail line after an apparent failure of its automated routing system. U.S. military has not released the contents of the train's cargo, though federal authorities have evacuated a 20-mile radius surrounding the wreckage. Though no official death toll has been given, initial reports indicate the deaths of over 40 enlisted men. Potential civilian casualties are believed to be much lower.
Newspapers talking about cyber terrorism, an information crisis, information warfare. Call it what you will, but realize that no American is safe until we mobilize our army.
Rescue workers, their information grid entirely disabled, were unable to respond to the crash for nearly an hour. Injuries became fatalities as to combine Nicolas, the Georgian president, still in hiding. Though his first wave of cyber terrorism focused on military targets, intelligence proposes that a large-scale civilian target could just as easily...
We have faced terror before and triumphed. I promise here to the American people that we will triumph again. Earth is too small a place for the perpetrators of these acts to hide. The United States and her allies will enact a justice that is swift, cruel, and absolute.
Oh, hell yeah. We got to get down to business right now. What is going on, everybody? Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's your boy, DKEN, and welcome back to Let's Play Splinter Cell. Now, before we commence this episode, do not forget to Hulk smash that like button, subscribe to my channel, share this with your boys and your families, follow me on Instagram, smash that bell notification button, and of course, as always, please sit back and enjoy. Ooh.
Time to get to work, Fisher. Let me reiterate.
Okay.
We cannot afford any casualties. The NSA doesn't operate in the U.S. We don't spy on other agencies.
I'm not here.
That's right. You've lost existence privileges until the mission's over.
Oh, God.
We've synced a timer on your offset to a pause in the ventilation system fans. You'll have a limited window of opportunity to use it for insertion.
Okay. Access the agency's central server to identify and locate the information leak. Any agency fatalities will result in mission failure. You are now equipped with a thermal vision headset. A pause in the ventilation system fan will present an opportunity for more stealth insertion. Oh yeah, I don't have much time. I cannot fuck around in this. And look at this. Hell yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Ooh, I don't know. Why don't you go check it out? Check it out. We have a window. There you go. Okay, we're inside. Okay. Front gate, maintenance area, main hall. We're here at number 2. This is where we gotta go. The CIA main server, war room, weapons testing department. Okay, I think it's quite clear as to where we should go. Check it out. I don't even have a fucking pistol. That sucks. Hold up. Belong there. Save it right here.
Who is that? Show yourself!
Copy that.
Got him. All right, what do you have? Sticky shooter. No, that's for another weapon. What is this? Okay, we got a guy that's patrolling around halls. Okay, we're gonna stick right around this area. No, I changed my mind. That was close. No, that's gonna trip the alarm. That's gonna set off the alarm. I can't let that happen. Let's see if I can grab one of these guys. Hold on. I don't like where this is going.
There's something back there.
That was somewhat close.
Back on.
Alright, I'm inside.
Are you going to be staying at the hospital? You mean when she wakes up? Listen, thanks for coming in. I know the last thing you want to be doing at a time like this is answering questions. I couldn't assume it was a coincidence. Thanks for your understanding. Let me know if there's anything we can do.
Here with Officer Winston, we've got double van go. That's where we need to go.
What is that?
That's an interesting way to distract someone. Let's see where this will take us. Hell yeah.
Just got word from our man inside. He says your F-2000's in place. You can retrieve it in the storage room behind the generator backup.
Goody.
I'd be ignorant not to arm you. Keep it holstered. One agency fatality means the mission's over.
What do we got here? Alrighty. Main server room code is 2019. Heightened security. Alrighty. Gotcha. Let's see what we got. Nothing.
Ah, hell.
Nice. Nice.
Come out with your hands up. held a man unconscious.
Gotcha. Alrighty. We're just gonna continue. I have no patience to wait anymore. Wait, did somebody just wake up? Or no? Okay. What do you got? All right. Technical services room door before the very end today. Be outside of your window. 7687. That's the server room. Nope, sorry, hang on a minute. 7687, my bad. Got it. Should have done that first. Okay, hold up. What do I got? Battery, the backup battery power room code is 110598. Alrighty. I'm surprised that nobody else heard the gunshots. Hey, look at this. My weapon. Ready? Thank God. I feel much safer with the firearm. Thank you.
Yeah, I guess. Do you know anybody who was hurt?
Gotcha. Server room. Now we know where to go.
Fisher, GPS shows you within sight of the server. Grim's daughter's standing by. She'll be ready to trace the lead as soon as you can get us access.
Nice. Good. That will help out a lot.
Due to recent events, all security personnel will remain at level 3 patrol until further notification.
I think I heard a noise.
You did not hear anything, sir. All right. Let's go straight into the server room. Here we go. They didn't drop anything that I needed, so let's get inside. Alrighty. We're in. Okay.
Hey, are you okay? What the hell?
Just making sure the coast is clear. All right, let's hide the bodies. All right, let's do it.
All right, Lambert. We're in.
Good. Grim?
I'm inside. Just there. The leak is a low security PC registered to one Mitchell Doherty.
Great. Doherty's PC is your new objective, Fisher. I'll upload the details to your opsat.
Nice. I'm just checking around to see if there's anything around here that I can pick up. Hold up. Ah, shit. Hold up. Okay. Okay. I made it this far, and I do not plan on delaying any longer. I see you.
Come out here where I can see you.
Honestly, I really don't care about the alarms. I care about getting the job done.
You're not supposed to be here.
Please note, there is no longer a smoking section in the cafeteria.
Yes, I understand
that.
All right, good.
To designated smoking terraces on the fifth floor.
Made it.
Well, tell Clarence I'm gonna have his ass in his badge for this. Because I'm looking at agency photographs of Red Bear on TV.
Uh-oh.
Find out what agency media
you in trouble, son.
Anything they haven't shown yet, get back before they do.
You shall get back to me, sir, immediately.
I don't know. I don't care. Fix it. Is that... Hello?
At least no gunshots went off. Is this his computer? Nope, it is not. Fuck. Oh, God. What do we have here? Okay, good. Hey, a flare. Tell me this is his... No? Great. I don't give a fuck about the turret, alright? I'm trying to find Doherty's computer. Let this end. Got it.
Found faces of the media in a secure data forwarding service in Holland. Another in Bangkok, three in Canada.
Any order?
Nope.
Take it back. Turn up the phone.
The foolish avarice and arrogance of a nation that still believes there is such a thing as a war of superpower.
Take it back to beliefs?
What, the chainsaw?
Mini 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 mini.
It's like a moaning in the background.
That still believes there is. That still believes there is.
No, it's like a
That's Doherty. Okay. Just like Lambert said, we're gonna stay out of his way. Got it.
Great work, Fisher. How are we doing, Grim?
Working on it. Very clever back door. Looks like Philip Nass's work. Bouncing to a server. Surf Kalina underscore VA, which is the Kalinatech building in... Oh, black hell. Somebody spotted me. They shut down.
We'll call back.
Fuck.
Fisher, we're gonna need you to bag Doherty.
What happened with Grim's daughter?
We'll worry about that. You worry about Doherty.
Copy.
Wait for him to take a smoke break. Make grabbing him easier. Details on your offset.
Copy.
Transformers coming from County Electric Supply and the backup generator. Agent Marx has been trying to sell us on the idea of electrostatic fuel bombs, but the last radius that affected a logic bomb activated in the hospital's archival system 70 hours earlier, approximately 10 p.m. on the 28th of October, effectively wiped out our chances of tracing the attack digitally. However, we do know how they gained access to the Transformers. These are hospital security access codes. The only parties who have these codes are us. If these codes came from CIA, E-files, then, excuse me,
yeah?
Yeah, I'm telling them about it now. Oh, hold on a sec. I'm gonna be a few minutes if you guys want to take a break. All right, I'm back.
You hear that? They're gonna take a break. So that means he's gonna be going on a smoke break right now. There he is. There you are, baby. Right there, right there. There you go, there you go. There you go. Get outside right now. Get the fuck outside right now, son. We ain't got all day.
Julie Wilkes is in position for extraction.
Hell yeah.
He's with Special Agent Baxter, an interrogations expert. They've got a disappearance truck parked in the back.
Okay. Smoking area. All right. Shit. Okay. Let's go. I just want to get this over with. Like, I'm done with this. Asshole. That's the guy. Hold on.
Whoa! What the hell's going on?
Don't worry about it.
Got him. Okay.
Go away.
This our friend?
That's the man. Where's Doherty?
I still have to get him.
We need to move quickly.
Lambert's freaking out over this Kalinatech thing.
I'll get him.
We're not going anywhere until you give me Doherty.
Alrighty, alrighty. You have my word. I'll get him. Alrighty. Thank you. Man, this was a long level. I kept failing left and right, up and down, like I just could not take it anymore. I seriously could not. Alright, gents, he's all yours.
We're not going anywhere until you give me Dart.
He's right here,
We're
asshole.
We're not going anywhere until you give me Dart. We're not going anywhere until you give me Dart.
I think I'm supposed to drop him.
Sarah?
No.
She's fine. The blackout spooked her, but she's completely alright. Don't get too emotional. Let's get out of here.
Thanks, Wilkes.
Oh, thank God. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes this episode of Splinter Cell, so thank you very much for watching. Do not forget to Hulk smash that like button, subscribe to my channel, share this with your boys and your families, follow me on Instagram, smash that bell notification button, and every single one of you, have a wonderful and blessed day. Peace out.